Das heißt, du hast einfach das Kabel, hast ein paar Windungen gemacht, wie eine Mantelwellensperre oder was?
Ja, einfach um die Kabelresonanz wegzukriegen.
A very small loop is usable for reception. But when used as a transmitting antenna, even if constructed with, for instance, 8 cm diameter copper pipe, it shows disappointing properties. A very small loop generates very high Q, unpractical small bandwidth, very large currents, very high capacitor voltages, and very high losses. This is an example of a small loop for an active broadband receiving antenna. Very small loops are good for receiving, not for transmitting. The maximal circumference of a capacitive tuned loop is 1/4 of a wavelength. It has good efficiency on that frequency and enables a relative thin radiator. If such a loop is to be tuned to more than one frequency band, that loop should have a circumference of 1/4 lambda for the highest frequency band. Golf Zero Charlie Whiskey Tango measured impedances on a 1/4 wave circumference loop. At the current maximum, the impedance was 5.5 ohms. A 1/4 lambda circumference loop has a relative high feedpoint impedance, is easier wideband matchable with a special constructed 3-to-1 transformer, allows a relative small copper diameter pipe, allows lower costs. The value of the RF current in the loop at the tuner capacitor is 2 times lower than in the current maximum of the loop. The value of the loop current is not constant around the 1/4 lambda circumference loop. LoopCalc gives therefore wrong calculations for 1/4 lambda circumference loops. Some people are convinced that the loop radiator must be constructed out of one piece of copper, very large diameter pipe. Every 1/10 of an ohm series resistance must be avoided for loss reasons. Even thin lead soldering must be avoided. That is not always true. A 1/4 lambda circumference loop generates much lower values of currents, voltages and losses. At 3.65 MHz, a 1/4 lambda circumference loop with a thin 1 cm diameter coax radiator shows maximal 1.8 dB loss. A practical 1/4 wavelength circumference capacity tuned loop enables a thinner radiator, transformer matching, immediately wideband perfect standing wave ratio, a 1 mm spaced air tuning capacitor, a simpler tuning mechanism. If that same loop is also be used on a lower frequency bands, its relative circumference in wavelength becomes smaller there. Then its feedpoint impedance drops to a much lower value, half frequency, 9 times lower impedance. And loop currents will rise to a higher value, causing the need for a thicker radiator in order to minimize losses on lower frequency bands. This simulation of a 1/4 lambda loop at low height, its tuning capacitor at the lowest point of the loop shows a maximum towards the sky and a minimum towards the ground. Positioning the tuning capacitor at the lowest point of a 1/4 lambda circumference loop, maximal RF radiation towards the sky, good ENVIS properties on 80 meter band, minimal radiation directed downwards, less chances of generate broadcast interference or television interference in consumer equipment below. Less reception of QRM from the house, mains and network cabling. When positioning the tuning capacitor at the lowest point of the loop, the highest part of the loop radiates best. That radiation is towards the sky. The minimum radiation and sensitivity is towards the roof, resulting in less RF in the building and less noise reception. The detailed description of this square loop is on my site www.pa0novemberhotelcharlie.nl. All radio frequency currents in conductors run in a very thin surface layer. These skin layers have a relative small cross-section per unit of width, resulting in a relative high value of high frequency resistance. This skin resistance is determined by the specific material resistance, the diameter of the conductor, and the AC frequency. Loop losses will below 15 MHz not influence the received signal to noise ratio. Received signals and noises are equally weaker. However, while transmitting for stations listening to you, these losses will result in at least 10 dB worse signal to noise ratio. The very short circumference of a very small loop can only radiate energy by generating very high currents. The largest part of the RF current will be dissipated into heat in the skin loss resistance. Such a very small loop is therefore mainly loaded by dissipating RF energy into heat. Its loading by radiation is small. Therefore, its loaded Q is very high. High Q is only wanted for non-radiating coils, like in receivers, but the transmitting loop antenna should radiate all power. A larger loop circumference is therefore needed. The loop will then be loaded by radiating energy, resulting in much lower loaded Q, much wider bandwidth, much lower capacitor voltages, much lower current values, much less heat losses. Here a calculation for a small loop for the 80 meter band with very thick 8 cm copper radiator. The maximum possible efficiency is only 11%, that is minus 10 decibel. It has an enormous high Q. It has a very small bandwidth, unusable for a single sideband on 80 meters. It has an unpractical low feed point impedance, and a matching transformer should have an impossible high turns ratio. Matching 250 ohms is only possible with a capacitive network, or a gamma match, or a small coupling loop. They all need experimentation for optimal performance. A capacity network can be asymmetrical. A gamma match is asymmetrical, causing asymmetrical feeding of the loop, therefore causing skewing transmission. The loop is not radiating upwards but at one side more than at the other side. This unbalanced feeding also can generate common mode currents, therefore TVI or PCI. Very high RF voltages exist at the tuning say, up to 10 kV peak, very high loop currents, and only 11 watts of the 100 watts power is radiated. The other 89 watts are generating heat into the loop conductor. Constant current around miscalculations. Loop calc give only good results for loops having a constant current around their whole circumference. Golf Zero Charlie Whiskey Tango monitored RF currents around a quarter lambda loop. these currents had not a constant value but varied. These calculations from LoopCalc, therefore, will only give good results for very small loops, much smaller than a quarter lambda circumference loop. Efficiency calculations on 80 meter on two larger than 1/20th lambda loops. Both loops are calculated for very thin radiators, 1 cm thick coax. A quarter lambda circumference loop showed 2 dB loss. A 1/8 lambda circumference loop showed 7 dB loss. In practice, these losses are even lower, because LoopCalc presumes a constant currents, which is not true for these loops, and these loops have much lower currents than LoopCalc calculates. The calculated efficiency of a practical loop 2.5 by 2.5 meters square, that is 10 meters circumference, that is only 1/8 lambda on 80 meters, the radiator of 35 mm copper pipe, compared with a half lambda dipole antenna, the losses of this loop are maximally 2 dB. I constructed such a loop antenna and have a few years experience with it. At the left, a schematic diagram, the transformer 3:1 for 40 meters and 9:1 for 80 meters has a speciality. In series with the secondary of the transformer is a series tuning capacitor. This capacitor tunes out the spreading self-inductance of the transformer and the connecting wires, resulting in a very wide band matching for a standing wave ratio lower than 1.5. On the right, dimensions for pipes. A 1/4 lambda circumference loop shows better properties than a very small loop. Much lower Q, much wider bandwidth, much lower capacitor voltages, much smaller currents, much less losses, better RF radiation. A capacitive tuned loop having the maximal allowable circumference of a quarter wavelength radiates its connected RF power the best.
Okay, also unten am Transceiver, na Donnerwetter.
Ja, ja.
Nee, da hab ich noch nie was von gehört. Du, dass das, na, wenn das funktioniert, der Zweck heiligt die Mittel, ne?